Okay, good morning, everybody. Daryl Price with D3, joined by Joshua Buff, also with D3. And today we'll be focusing on D3's ERP, and the focus will be on costing. So Joshua will be leading today's discussion and going over the modules that are within D3's ERP. So with that, Joshua, I'll go ahead and turn it over to you for today's content.
Thank you, Daryl. So as Daryl said, we're going to go ahead and talk about costing, removing the guesswork, a brief outline of what we're going to cover. We're going to cover the key costing elements, what you need to absolutely make sure you know your cost. I've got a couple examples from real life on some mistakes that were made and how D3 ERP can help fix those. And then we're going to talk about the different types of costing within D3 ERP. So we're going to go ahead and get started here. I'm going to go ahead and log in. An important thing to note about D3 ERP is that it is cloud-based. So you're going to get all of the benefits of cloud functionality, or browser functionality rather, multiple tabs, being able to work in different tabs at the same time, those classic browser shortcuts. That's just a side note there. So we'll go ahead and jump into the four key costing elements. So the first thing that D3 ERP takes a look at is the material cost. And this is pretty much as it sounds, exactly what does my raw material cost? The next thing is labor cost. So this is the amount of money that you've deemed per labor per hour. And you can set that per work center, per the entire shop. You can customize that by the actual operation that's being done. So if you've got one area that has a higher labor cost and one area that has a lower labor cost, you can configure those, and then it calculates the exact amount of time that that product spends in that area to give you an estimated cost of what you spend on labor for that stage. The next thing is going to be overhead. So you say, hey, you've got your overhead cost for insurance, for your building, for, you know, just all those little things that you figure into overhead that aren't a direct cost to the product. You set an overhead rate, and it will also calculate that per area or stage, and you can have different overhead rates per area or stage. And then the last one is going to be missed charges. So this is going to be like outsourcing, any tooling, if you have scrap, excess material, those types of things also go into the cost. And those are kind of the four foundational elements that are required to cost. You know, you have to know exactly what you're going to pay, so you don't charge the wrong thing or you overprice it and bid yourself out of the market. So we're going to go ahead and talk about the estimated versus the default cost. So there's two different ways that CTEC or D3 ERP powered on CTEC calculates the cost. Estimated cost is exactly what it sounds like. It's a projection of what the cost will be. I'm sure you all know why that's important. You want to make sure that your product's going to be viable in the market. You want to make sure that you can produce it at your target rate. The other thing is the default cost. And so we're going to take a look at that in a little while, but that's basically what, if I don't have any of my other data, what does that actually cost? So we're going to go ahead and take a look here, a real life example of the estimated material cost. So this is the bill of material overview. So as you can see, I've got subcomponent 1, 2, and 3. And under the cost record, you can kind of see that I've got some values filled out there. And so it shows the data there in a very simple view. To make subcomponent 1, my cost is $34.76. So it's a pretty simple view. Now say, hey, you want to look down and see what goes into that cost. You can just hit this little arrow here. And it's gonna fill out all the components that go into that and fill out their costs as well. So then you get, how many do I have for the top unit? All the different costs associated. You'll also see on my screen, I've got labor and overhead. I don't have values filled out for those. So that's why it shows 0 here, but it puts it in a very simple view. So it's very easy to know what you're paying or what you paid. And that's critical to being able to cost. I've got a story here for you, and this is a real life example from a previous client. This is on the purchasing side of things. This client had a widget, you know, that they had outsourced completely. It was manufactured somewhere else, and then it had a coating that was put on, and then it had a shipping in between both of those stages, and then back to the client. Their annual usage was around 16,000 units. they didn't have a good way to cost the product. They just had a bunch of invoices, and the ERP system they were using wasn't sophisticated enough to easily present this data to them. So when they added everything up and they double checked it three or four times, they thought that their cost was $15 per unit. So then they made a deal with a different supplier for $10 a unit. You know, that sounds pretty good. You're going to save $5 per unit. Well, it turns out after they implemented D3 ERP by Powered on CTech, it turns out their actual cost was $5. So what they had actually done was made a deal to spend $80,000 more annually just because they didn't know what their true cost was. So that's pretty important to know exactly what you're paying for something. A note on how D3 ERP was able to solve that for them is it pulled in the cost when they issued a PO, it added the cost of that PO to that component, and then shipping was added to that component. So it actually pulled exactly what they were paying from their ERP and added it to their costing module. So that's a pretty powerful feature. And as you can see, I mean, luckily D3 ERP caught this because they would have been spending quite a bit of extra money for the same product. So that's a pretty good example there of a victory for D3 ERP. The next thing we're going to go ahead and talk about is the default cost. And so this is going to be auto assigned cost. And so this is kind of a, what is the last thing that we used it on? What is historical examples of what we actually paid? So this isn't going to be estimated. This is going to be this, we actually paid this, and this is our actual cost. So how that configures this, because this is somewhat of an automated process, is this going to be vendor defined cost. Kind of how I mentioned a minute ago in the POs, when you issue a PO, it says, okay, I'm paying $5 a unit for this, and adds it there. If D3 ERP can't see the last, the vendor defined cost, it will look at the last purchase record. If it doesn't find the last purchase record, it will find the average part or average cost of the part. So this is someone like you import inventory, like in the implementation, you say, okay, on average, I pay $5 or $10. It looks at that. If none of those exist, it will look at what do we last sell this price for? So then it looks at sales records to make sure that you're not accidentally going to sell it for the wrong price or cost yourself out. And again, that last sold price, that last resale price is the last resort. Typically, you don't get there, but in rare cases, you will. But that's really just to protect you. It also gives you visibility on the life of the cost. It does costing based on the individual component. And as you can see on my screen here, you can actually see the costing on each individual component there, and even several levels down. It's done automatically on each part. I know that if some of you out there, like a previous client of mine, you know, you used to do it in this crazy Excel spreadsheet that had 100 different formulas, and you double checked it and rechecked it, and you just prayed it was correct, but you still didn't have full confidence in it. So this takes that out of the equation. It does it automatically for you in the background. Actual cost. So this is okay. So let's take a look at for the sales order I've got. Let's take a look and see what did I actually pay to ship this product. So we're going to go ahead and jump over to this other tab here, and this is the part details tab. And this actually tells me what was my total cost to ship this product. So as you can see over here on the right hand side, I've got the material estimate, which is $55.39. The outsource / labor estimate was $80. And then my overhead estimate was $40. So it breaks down all those different categories for you. I don't have a resale price in here, but this is an example of your costing. So this will show you what did I actually pay to ship this order. And this is, as you can see, this is on the invoice right there in the top right, or yeah, right-hand side, left-hand side, sorry. It shows invoice here. So this was an actual order that was shipped. So you can actually take a look and see exactly what we paid for that. I've got another story here, and this is from another client. And this is about they had priced their product incorrectly because they also had that same issue of doing spreadsheets and invoices and not knowing their exact labor costs or their overhead costs or material costs even due to scrap and other reasons. Basically, this company was selling a unit of around $400 less than their cost. So it wasn't even less than what they should have been making a profit. It was that they were paying $400 basically to send this to the customer. You know, they priced it at X and they were selling it for $400 less than that. And this was pretty detrimental because this had been in full production for around 18 months. And when that was added up, it was around $125,000 annually. You know, so they lost quite a bit of money just shipping this product because they simply didn't know what their product cost truly was. So not only did they lose out on the profit, they actually were losing money over their cost. So it's a pretty powerful tool to know exactly what you're paying. So even if it does make it through and you sell it at a loss, you can take a look and make sure and readjust and move on without taking that hit. This was another thing that D3 ERP fixed for that client, was they were able to see exactly what they paid and react accordingly. So they're no longer taking that loss every time they ship the product. So something that's important to note here is that the estimated versus actual cost, there's a little bit of a difference there. Estimated costs work without specific data as to which parts were actually consumed and how much labor was actually logged against the order. So the benefit of looking at this view here is you can see what was truly logged against this individual work order. You know, so it's not saying that every work order is going to be exactly the same. Maybe it takes a guy 15 more minutes to do this issue or do this work order because he ran into an issue or he had 10% more scrap. So your cost varies. And so that's one of the benefits is that tracking it per work order is you can say, oh, for whatever reason, I'm typically wasting 2% of my material in this job. How can we take a look and get that down? So it gives you good visibility to know in target areas where you need to reduce waste or reduce time or targets like that. That's pretty valuable. And as you can see, it's pretty easy to view this information. It doesn't make it hard. It's not complicated. It really is a great solution. Daryl?
Thank you, Joshua. And so next week, we will be focusing on our next session, which is purchasing. Know what you have and knowing what you need. As we've covered today, D3's ERP is built on C-Tech, and that is the relationship we've set to really bring a very good, solid ERP system to the market. And as you go through these and you identify, you know, as a company, if you're looking for an ERP system or if you've got one and you know that it's not serving the needs in some of the areas as Joshua has identified, please feel free to reach out and we can certainly dive into more detail with what this system can do and how it can help solve some of the problems or challenges that you're faced with. So that concludes for today's session, and we'll look forward to next week where we'll jump into purchasing. Thanks a lot.